Welcome again. In this video, we broadly learn the process for adding library dependencies, such as CSS or JavaScript, to your theme. Let's begin. In the web development community, there are many open-sourced, shared, or Creative Commons assets that are so useful that they become essential parts of a themer's toolbox. Sometimes these assets or libraries are intended to enhance your CSS. For example, normalize.css is a CSS style sheet that helpfully fixes a number of odd quirks present in the rendering of CSS between different browsers. Many themers want to include it because it simplifies the creation of style sheets. Other assets, such as JavaScript libraries like jQuery or AngularJS, are used in a similar manner to save time when themers are designing common aspects of a site's user interface. Drupal Core includes a number of useful libraries that you can enable as dependencies for your theme, such as normalized CSS and jQuery, like we mentioned before. You can view what's available by looking in the core directory of Core Assets Vendor. In addition to what comes with Drupal, you can declare whatever libraries and dependencies you need for your theme. The process of adding assets to your theme is a three-part process. First, define the asset library and any specific containers in your libraries.yaml file. Then, declare the assets with the library's key in your info.yaml file. And finally, reference those assets as needed in the appropriate CSS or HTML.twig files, which we'll learn later. Whenever you wish to add assets to your project, you need to define them in a .libraries.yaml file you create in your theme folder. Soon, we'll create simplesmart.libraries.yaml, and within this file, you can further organize your assets into containers. This allows you to, for example, organize CSS assets for your mobile site into one container versus CSS assets for a desktop site or a print version. If you're adding a JavaScript asset that has a lot of information associated with it, you can give it its own container to keep all that information together. When selecting a name for a container, it's best to keep it short and descriptive. You can use periods and hyphens in the name, as well as letters. A common container you may come across is called global-css. Once you add an asset library, you must tell Drupal about it in your theme's info.yaml file. You use the same procedure whether you are adding CSS assets or JavaScript assets. The syntax looks similar to this. Within a library's key, you have the machine name of your theme, and the second part is the container name. So for this example, SimpleSmart is the machine name of our theme, and the second part, global-css, is the name of the container that is defined in simplesmart.libraries.yaml. Adding an asset library into simplesmart.libraries.yaml makes it load for all pages using your theme. Note, we can load a library conditionally, but it does require editing of Twig and PHP templates, which will be covered later in this course. As a final reminder, whenever you make changes to your theme, it's best to always clear cache after making changes to templates. If you make a change to a template and it doesn't have the effect you expect, first, make sure you made the change to your custom theme and not a different copy of the file, then clear your cache. Broadly speaking, there are three ways to clear the cache. The first is to do it manually with the push of a button by visiting Configuration and then Development, Performance, and clicking on Clear All Caches. Of course, it's recommended that you have the Admin Toolbar module installed, and if you do, you can flush all caches by selecting it from the menu. If you have Drush installed, then simply enter Drush CR to clear all caches with Drush. Excellent. Nice job on getting an overview of how to add libraries as dependencies to your theme. Remember, this is a three-part process. First, define the asset library and any specific containers in your libraries.yaml file. Then, declare the assets with the library's key in your info.yaml file, and finally, reference these assets as needed in CSS files or html.twig files. Coming up, let's go ahead and add some CSS assets to your theme. Happy learning.